What up, YouTube? This is Smokehouse Beats. I made this for you. You can get at me at smokehousebeats.com. Subscribe on my YouTube, Ty Hoover. You can get on my Instagram, smokehousebeats3. And get all the latest updates on everything. All my tutorials will be on YouTube. That's Ty Hoover. And beats. Updates on videos, stuff like that. So what I'm about to do is show you how to get started on New Window, which is the same thing as Cubase. So if you a Cubase user, you can use New Window, vice versa. You can use Sonar. You can pretty much use the same plugins. I mean, software that's similar. They all like. Basically, they're all the same anyway. So what you do is open the window. You're going to come to this blue screen. You go to File, New Project, because you're starting a new project. Then your new project box pop up. You want to empty template. I got templates that I made. And I'll show you how to make that later. So we're just going to go to Empty. And then the project folder. You want to set the folder to where all your audio files and punch-ins and all that stuff, they go somewhere. So this will be the folder where they go into. Otherwise, it'll be scattered all over your computer. So you make a folder right there, say audio, and they'll just be going in there. You can make one by create, hit create. It'll say new folder, name it audio. But you wouldn't have to do that right now. I think an audio folder would pop up automatically, and then you just hit OK, basically. Now, this is your workflow screen. Basically, this blue area right here, you got two blue areas, and you got this white area where all the waves going to be at. So right here is where you right-click, or you can use project, add, and audio. You can add an audio track or instrument track, MIDI track, and so on. But mainly the quick way is to just right click in here, and you can just add the same thing. So what you're going to do is add an audio track. Most of the time, if you're doing a two-track beat, like a MP3, then you would have one stereo track. So you click OK. Now you got a stereo track up here. And then you're going to need mono tracks for your vocals. So you right-click in the same gray area, add a track, and change where it says stereo configuration to mono. And because why you do that is because your beat is in stereo. Stereo meaning two speakers, left and right. Your headphones have two speakers. You have two ears, basically. So you're gonna listen in stereo. That's both sides being played through at the same time. So mono, you have one chord coming from your mic and it's going into one input into your interface. That's mono, one singular. So you plug in the mic, even if it's one USB mic, you still plugging in one chord, and it should be a mono input. Because once you finish with the tracks that you use, you're probably gonna end up with multiple tracks. Once you finish with the song, this is going to be exported as a stereo track. So in the end, the finished product is in stereo. So you just have to mix. So back to this, you can do two. We're gonna do three tracks mono. So now you got three tracks mono. You can name them. Double clicking in there. You can name it whatever. Beat. Right here is how you, this would be the vocal. Let me see. Vocal one. And then right here is how you record. Pretty much everything you wave over, it'll tell you what to do. That's in any software. If you just be patient, just wave over it, it'll say what it do. Write, enable, read, enable. Monitor, which you probably never use, but this is what you're going to use all the time, is record. And this, edit channels, which is the EQs. So up here would be your mixer channel. Let me see. So that was the mixer channel for each track that you put up there. So let's say you wanted this track. And these are the settings for that track. So right here you have up to 8 effects, basically. They call them plugins. But 8 effects you can put up onto one track. So you can throw an EQ on there. You can pretty much throw whatever you want on there. I got too much shit. There we go. Got that. And each one of them has his own presets too. So you can set this the way you like it. Set the EQ the way you like it. And another main fact that I left out is go to an empty track and you want to add a group channel. Actually, you want to add 2 group channels. And this is so you can save on processing power on your computer by using the main mix and plugins that you're going to use on the group tracks instead of each individual tracks. And you don't, it saves you from using all those tracks, all those effects on your main vocal tracks and stuff like that a lot. So basically you go add a group track, you click on the count, same thing, add 2, make sure they're in stereo, hit okay. Now, easy way. This is my vocal. Let's just say this is the hook. We're going to send the vocal to group 1, which we're going to call main vocal. And then group 2 will be hook. So you're going to click on that, make sure it's highlighted, come over here to the stereo out, click on that, come down to group, send it to main vote, bam, just like that. Same thing with this, click on the hook, go to stereo outs, send that output straight to group hook. And then this will be like a fill-in, send that to whatever, group hook, it don't even matter, but they there. And for now, that's pretty much it. You can check my next videos for the next instructions on how to record and more workflow, a little bit more about the program. Just don't forget to subscribe. And that's about it. Smokehouse Beats.